want this game scene to be responsible for telling what game are we playing, if it's the jumping game or the rolling game, for example. So to do this, there is a very nice and tidy way to perform this logic. What we want to do is, we want to go to the game controller, and before the first method declaration, we're going to type this public enum, and then we're going to type this game mode. We can open and close curly braces, and here we're going to type two names. So we're going to type jumpers, a comma, and we're going to type rollers. So what is happening here? When we make an enum, we're going to make a kind of a structure that can have different values, okay? So in this case, there are going to be only two possible values, jumpers and rollers. Or we could add other ones here, like shooters, for example. But the thing is, internally, these names are not strings. They are integer numbers. They are simply numbers. So this one is 0, this one is 1, and this one is 2. So why do you use enums? We want to make this readable. Okay, we want to make sure that it's going to be very easy for us to understand what game we are playing. And now that we define this enum here, we can come here in the gameplay and we can type public, and then we're going to type game mode with uppercase G, and now we can repeat game mode with a lowercase g. If we save this and we go to Unity, we wait for a little bit, and once you look here, you're going to have this game mode field, and notice that we made a very convenient and very easily readable drop down menu here. Okay, so we have jumpers, but if we click, we can choose rollers or shooters. And we can do this while we are editing the game in Unity, so you can have another teammate to work in this game and simply switch what game mode they want to play here to test it out. Okay, this is very good for testing your games, and this is exactly what we want. Now, what we want to do here is, in the start method, we only want to add the jumping enemy object if we are in the jumpers game mode. Okay, so there are several ways to do this. One of them is to simply type if game mode, and now we are using the variable, okay, with a lowercase g. If game mode equals two equal signs, as we're making a comparison, to game mode dot jumpers. Okay, this is the comparison that we want to make. We want to see if game mode contains the same value as game mode jumpers, which is, in this case, internally, 0. Now we're going to put these lines between the curly braces right after this if block, and we can save this, and we can confirm if the jumping enemies is still appearing. Okay, so let's try that out. Press play, and we have the jumping enemy right there. Okay, now if we stop the scene and we change the game mode to rollers and we press play without having to wait for another compilation, no enemies appear here. Okay, so the player can move freely in this game and, well, nothing special is going to happen. But there's another way that we can do this. Okay, so it's going to be fine if we use if and then we use an else if, then game mode equals to game mode dot rollers, and keep writing the code, but we can use a switch block as well. That is going to be easier for us to read, and, well, it's always good to know different techniques to do the same thing, okay? And this is very common when we are comparing the values inside an enum. We can make a switch block. So we can type switch, so in between parentheses we're going to put game mode, okay, simply like that. It's almost like we are calling a function. And between curly braces, we're going to type all the possible cases, okay, all the possible outcomes that can be inside game mode, all the possible values. So I'm going to type here case, okay, and now I'm going to type game mode dot jumpers and a colon. And here I'm going to type all of the things that are going to happen if we are in the jumpers game mode. In our case, we can just select these two lines, we can cut them and paste here. This is what's going to happen if we are in the jumpers mode. And after we're done with this, we can type break and a semicolon. So this is like we just like we typed, okay? It's if game mode equals to game mode jumpers. Now we can type case game mode dot rollers a colon, and we just add break because we are yet to do something here. Okay, and well, this is just the template that we're going to use. We can now delete these things. We can save this. Let's go to Unity. Wait for the compilation to be finished. And now that this is done, I'm going to press the play button. OK, Okay, and as you can see, as we are in rollers mode, nothing appeared. But if we switch back to jumpers, then the jumping enemy should be here. Okay, so there it is. All right, and one thing that we want to do here that is going to be interesting while we are developing the game is, if you decide to make all of the game modes and by accident you have another game mode active by accident, you might be feeling something is wrong. Okay, so imagine we are here and we put in rollers, but we wanted to test the jumpers, and maybe and that is very common what I'm about to say, and maybe we still think it's in jumping mode. We're going to press play, then the jumping enemy is not going to appear. We're going to spend minutes and maybe spend a lot of time trying to figure out what's going to happen, and then realize that we were just in the wrong option. So what we might want to do is give a tip, okay, give a hint to ourselves that a mode is yet not implemented. So in this case, we have case game mode.folders colon, and then here we can put a message, debug.log. And then between parentheses, we can type this case or this game mode wasn't implemented. Okay, because it's not doing anything here. It's not spawning any enemies. Okay, they're just not appearing. Okay, and also instead of typing log, we can type log warning. Okay, so it's going to appear differently in Unity. Now, if we save this and go to Unity, we press the play button. And if the game executes, we're going to see a warning. It says this game mode wasn't implemented. Okay, so this is good. This is going to help us a lot and even help other people that are going to play our game. And also, we just have this for game mode rollers. We need to add shooters as well here, as this is an option. So we could type case game mode dot shooters. And a column. This works. Okay, we can bundle different lines, different case lines together to result in the same outcome. But another way to type this, okay, another way of saying, hey, jumpers work like this, but all of the other ones are simply going to raise a warning, is to replace this with the keyword default. Okay, this is like the else. Okay, in case nothing else was defined here, all of the other outcomes are going to come to this. This game mode wasn't implemented. Okay, so we can save this, and if we move to the shooters game mode, then we should see pretty much the same thing. Okay, we press play, and we have this game mode wasn't implemented. So now that we have this, now that we have all of the groundwork necessary for adding new game modes, we can work on the roller enemies.